Cuckhead is a good game. It consists of a bunch of run and gun missions and bosses. The bosses are extremely unique and prove to be very distinct from each other. Now, I have never played a game like this before. Cuckhead was the first ever run and gun type of title I've ever played, and I was told prior to playing this that it was not going to be giving me a good experience or hold my hand, even in the beginning of the game, excluding the tutorial. And boy, was I in for a fucking treat. Yo, to all of the Moldenhauers and the rest of the Cuphead team, I thank you and appreciate you for this charming work of craftsmanship. Deadass, I am so serious. This game fucked me up time and time and time and time again, but I just could not give up. Like Dunkey mentioned, shout out to Dunkey by the way, persistence is the key term, the perfect fucking term for this game. And another term that was mentioned in his Game Critics video was focus, which is the importance of understanding how something works and how you get around those obstacles. What is Cuckhead mostly praised for? Undoubtedly its art style. And that's fine, that's good. You want to have something that looks visually appealing or pleasing to the eyes. But when it is something that is inspired by 1930s cartoons in this modern day or modern age of gaming and it's praised, you created something that's never been done before. At least, I think. What is Cuckhead mostly disliked for? Its difficulty. Remember, this was the first run and gun game I've ever played. I knew exactly what I was getting myself into. Remember persistency and focus? Well, those were the two main things that pushed me to finish all of the running guns, and it's what pushed me to defeat those incredibly unique and challenging bosses. I already knew the game had a nice look to it, but did I have fun? Well, the soundtrack is amazing, the game has a very nice linear pacing to it, and the controls are extremely responsive. I did get my ass beat a lot during my playthroughs of this game, but did that tarnish or hinder my experience? No. And that's what made it fun. That's what made this experience somewhat refreshing because I've never played anything like this before. It boils down to focusing, persistency, and adapting. Once you've understood that Cuckhead is not an easy game, thanks to your persistency and adaptation, you don't even realize that you're having fun, but subconsciously, you are. This is just a different experience because you've never had anything like this before. Just because one is not like the other doesn't mean its worth is meaningless. You're going to get cucked by Cuphead a lot. Also, that's the reason why I've been calling it Cuckhead this entire time, because you're going to get cucked a lot. Take the risk or don't play it.